Greetings of the day. Myself Gaurav Goel is here in front of you all to present my studio work of Monsoon 2021 Project Procurement Management, guided by Professor Reshma Shah and Mr. Maulik Shah. So these are the contents of my presentation, starting with the similar project studied to procurement of contractors and consultants, and ending up with my in-depth top selected topic of financial bid and its comparison. So the main objective of the studio was to establish an appropriate procurement strategy and develop procurement rules and bidding systems as the part of construction project, and explore various stages which are important in the procurement process and set procedural necessaries for the completion of project. And as a learning outcome of the studio, I have been acquainted with the procedural knowledge of procurement, public procurement works and bidding systems, and inculcate the context and reason underlying the procurement process and value of action. Starting with the methodology of the studio, we have modes of study of methods and modes of procurement. We have studied procurement strategies and routes for a proposed project to final out methodology was analyze go and no go decision. So this is the weekly output, starting from week one of understanding the project and formulation of project requirements, with continuing the expert sessions by Mr. Snehal sir, continued by Surin sir, and through that we have done our mid semester review. Meeting with that, we have continued with our other expert sessions by Mr. Chintan Desai and Advocate Udayan Vyas, and completed with the end semester review. Starting with the details of the similar project studied, the aim of the exercise was to study six similar types of projects, and that can be highway, road infrastructure for me as I have selected for infrastructure projects. And through this exercise, I was able to make a comparison between similar nature of projects on basis of cost, location, type and contract selected, and how the work packages have been divided in the various projects. Starting with that, I have first taken Ahmedabad-Vadodara Expressway, which is completed, then the Ahmedabad-Dholera Expressway, which is completed, which is under construction and is being executed under EPC mode. So next was Purvanchal Expressway, Mumbai-Nagpur Expressway, Ganga Expressway and Delhi-Mumbai Expressway. Out of all the studied similar projects, Ahmedabad-Vadodara Expressway is the only project which have been completed and which was not having more than one packages, which was completed by IRB infrastructure. And rest all the projects have been divided into various packages from starting from 4 to 52, and all had different types of contracts, starting with DBFOT, design, build, finance, operate and transfer, and engineering procurement and construction, that is EPC. Three of them were under EPC, two of them have been executed under DBFOT, and one project which I have selected for my further study is being constructed under 31 projects under EPC mode and 21 under HAM mode. So these are the routes of the selected projects for similar study: Ahmedabad-Vadodara Expressway, Ahmedabad-Purvanchal Expressway, Mumbai-Nagpur Expressway and Ganga Expressway. Starting with the proposed projects, in this exercise we have studied the features of the project and prepared a project family tree to understand that how a project works from planning stage to the execution task stage. So through the exercise, I was able to learn details about the large scale projects and develop an understanding about know why from how the total length of the project is divided into various packages. And the study of this project helped me in preparing a project family tree for the selected expressway. Delhi-Mumbai Expressway. This expressway is having a length of 1350 kilometers with a project cost of 19,000 crores approximately, including the land acquisition cost. It is an 8-lane expressway which can be expanded further in future to 12 lanes. So the total capital expenditure estimated till now is of this project is 53,849 crores, out of which it will be funded through a combination of debt and equity with total depth of 48,464 crores, and the debt funding raised till date is 9,731 crores by SBI, Punjab National Bank, Bank of Maharashtra and Exim. Selected this third package, third section, starting with all the packages, I have selected third section of the project, and in that third section, I have taken this third package, Vadodara KIM Expressway, which is having a bid project cost of 1,712 crores, and it execution period of 2 years with owning and op maintenance operation and maintenance of 15 years. So the client is NHAI, concessionaire is Patel Vadodara KIM Expressway Private Limited, and there are various independent engineers, and the lender is Yes Bank. So starting up with the project family tree, the plan has been made under Government of India Planning Commission 11th 5-year plan, and that was further divided into two programs which have combined into NICDC, formerly which was known as DMICDC, which has taken the project to Delhi Mumbai Expressway under National Road Transport Policy and divided into 4 phases of the Delhi Faridabad Sohna, Sohna Vadodara and Vadodara Virar and Virar JNPT, which are having total of 52 packages as discussed earlier. So this is the project timeline. The project have been started in 2018 with a letter of award, and presently it is up to its finishing stage, and after that it will be in operation and maintenance period for 15 years. Starting with the next exercise of BID team. BID team is made up of specialists from various industries who collaborate to carry out the process of project managing, and it should have all the necessary abilities and knowledge to respond to professionally to the client's need. So that way, the BID team consists of BID manager, consultants, BID writers, technical team, legal advisors, BID executive, proofreaders, and BID coordinators. And many. This is a proposed BID team for consultant, which have been prepared by me after studying various tender documents and tender drawings, which are required on taking on basis of the scope of work of each of the BID team members. These are the various publications which we have referred as a part of the literature study of the studio, that consists of FIDIC documents, NITI Aayog, World Bank guidelines, and various specifications. Procurement process of consultants. So the main objective of this exercise was to establish technical learning, economical and financial viability of the project, and prepare detailed project reports. And through this, I was able to carry out what the procurement process of consultant is and selecting a proper procedure for that. So out of all the various selection methods available for procurement of consultants, that is QCBS, LCS, QBS, CQS and SSS, I have selected quality cost based selection, that is QCBS. The selection of consultants for the project carries off various steps, starting from the announcement and pre-qualification till the agreement, and these are the various scope of work of all the consultants which are required in a project. So there are various benefits of quality and cost based selection, because of which I have selected this method for procurement of consultant for the proposed project. It consists that quality and cost both have equal weightage, proper weightage, through which the project consultant can be selected. So because in today's world, quality as well as cost both are the important parameters which we need to consider while selecting a executing any of the projects and selecting a consultant. So this method helps to have a proper balance between quality as well as cost, while in rest of the procurement process methods, we don't have the combination of both of them altogether. Either we have cost or we have quality, and this is shown over here. So Evaluation criteria of QCBS selected procurement route is shown here. Initially, the technical technical evaluation is done, in which if the consultant obtains 75 marks minimum, then he declares that passed and considered for financial evaluation. And in financial evaluation, the scores have been calculated, and after that, the combined evaluation is done. For the combined evaluation, technical as well as finance both have individual weightages for their proposals. After doing the calculations, for my project, I propose the weightage of technical evaluation as 80% and financial evaluation as 20% as per FIDIC guidelines. Starting with the procurement process for contractors, there are various types of contracts available for selecting the contractors: lump sum project, lump sum contract, item rate contract, percentage rate contract, and EPC contract and PPP project contract. So, out of all this, for my selected packages, the existing type of contract is HAM, hybrid annuity mode, which is implemented under public-private partnership mode and executed as design, build, finance, operate contracts. So, what is HAM mode? In simple words, it is a mixture of EPC as well as BOT, annuity, where government only provides 40% of the project cost and rest of the 60% project cost is to be managed by the contractor. Over here, the chart properly defines a DBFOT contract. Various types of contract types for selection of the contractors, I would like to recommend EPC type of contract for my proposed project. The reasons for the same are that over here the private players bears virtually zero risk, and the timeline to construct the project reduces very nicely, and it creates a comfortable base to lure investors to carry out the EPC work, as well as all the responsibilities are bared by the government that are raising the capitals, procuring clearances, and private builders construct roads. Thus, the significant surge in road construction pace is expected. The list of exercises undertaken in the studio are as shown over here. Out of all these exercises, for this presentation, I have chosen three topics for in-depth presentation, which are proposed financial bid format, study of contracting firms and their awards won, and drafting pre-bid clarification format. Starting with the pre-bid clarification format, over in this exercise, a structure of pre-bid clarification was studied for various tenders, and after studying them, a pre-bid clarification structure was proposed by me for the selected project. Pre-bid conference of the bidders are conveyed at specified date, time, and venue as specified in the tender document. As shown over here, generally, the pre-bid clarification meeting is conducted after 25th day from the date of NIT. This meeting allows the contractors to prepare any query that they have ahead of the time, study the solicited paperwork, and prepare to speak with the owner when the opportunity arises. As well as this gives a clear understanding between the bidder as well as the client. So this is the format to reply to pre-bid queries in case there is any revision to after checking the queries in the tender document. So the format to give the reply to the revisions is as such, that the document in which the revision is to be made, the particular clause names, the clause reference and existing provision, And after the revision, the revised provision is also mentioned over here. Financial bid. Financial bids of various bid documents were studied and of various projects were compared. Learning outcome of this is the financial bid is proposed and an analysis of all packages of a project is. So this is the format of financial bid proposed by me for the selected package of EPC. Along with this, various annexures are to be submitted which are specified in the RFP document. So that have not been attached because those are the same as given in the tender documents. Those formats cannot be changed. This is just an example of how the final amount of figure which they have to quote an EPC in an EPC project is shown. This is shown over here that the details of the project are written over here. The quantity is length is written 31 kilometers. Quantity is written in square meters of the width, and the total amount in words as well as in figures is mentioned. And to that, either the bidder will provide a premium or a discount, which is to be mentioned, and the final bid price is to be mentioned over here. The projects won and the financial bids quoted by the bidder was for the elevated road Kolkata Road, NH34, NHDP Phase 2, Pune Metro, Coastal Road Project and Mumbai Metro. So these are the various amount of the estimated contract value and the bidded contract value by the contractor. And the interpretation was done for differences in crores of estimated contract value as well as the bid contract value. So we can see that there is a huge variation in the estimated cost as well as the bid contractor. There is no project won by them in which they have quoted below or to the point of estimated project cost. The percentage variation is very high, more than 1.5 in every project, and in majority of the projects the variation is more than 20%. From this, it can be interpreted that while doing a PPP model under HAM, they have bidded about 20%, and while doing the coastal road project, their bidded cost was more than 180% of the estimated cost, which may be due to the fault of the client for making the wrong estimates. HCC has studied financial bids of two packages of Delhi Mumbai Expressway, that is 27 and 28. In both of them, a huge variation has been seen. That in one of the packages, the estimated cost and the bidded cost both are having a huge variation, and the percentage variation is in positive direction. That it is more than almost 80% than the estimated cost, while in the other project, the estimated cost is higher and the bidders have bidded lower than the estimated cost, more than 10 to 20% less. So the reason might be that in case of 27th package, the GSV has won the package due to its being a local contractor for which they have quoted very less, because the mobilization of the resources will be a positive point for them, as they will be able to easily mobilize the resources at low cost, while for others it might be a higher gamble. While in 28th package also, GSV has won the project as it was the lowest bidder. The same reason applies. So this is the graph of percentage variation. As we can see, in the initial five packages, the bidded cost is more than the estimated cost. More than 3% of variation is seen. And while in the rest of the seven packages, the bidded cost is less than the estimated cost. I would like to express my gratitude towards Professor Reshma Shah, Mr. Maulik Shah, Ms. Meher Kalra, my parents, industry experts, expert session speakers, interviews, for their time and assistance. I would also like to thank jurors and the evaluators for their opinions and reviewing my work, which have helped me in enhancing my quality of work and producing a good output. I would also like to thank my friends for their assistance in developing the final output. With this, I would like to conclude that as a part of the studio, the exercises performed helped me in understanding about know-how and know-why of the project procurement management, which gave me a clarity about the key components of the construction industry, that is bid and its management, which I was not aware about. The in-depth study of various tenders and projects have helped me in enhancing my knowledge and understanding about the large-scale projects which are there in the industry to boost the infra of the project country.